special edition of the Rocket Report this week as I have some tragic news on the death of a major performer in the Seattle music scene. This Monday afternoon, Andrew Wood, lead singer for the popular band Mother Love Bone, was pronounced dead from complications resulting from a drug overdose. Mother Love Bone was one of the most popular and successful groups in the Northwest. They're considered one of the few bands that actually helped draw the national spotlight to Seattle. Wood was a highly charismatic singer that was in the top class of Seattle's performers, and he was one of the most visible members of any band on the Seattle club scene. When interviewed by The Rocket last year, Wood showed off his usual charm. "I've been training for this all my life," he said. "I remember when I was 9 or 10, and I would wait until my parents would leave and go down to my room and put on Kiss Alive really loud. I live for that." Andrew Wood, one of the most alive frontmen in Seattle rock and roll, dead in his prime.
Try to pull this off. I'm Andy's dad. I just want you guys to know that I'm real proud to be Andy's dad. It wasn't too long ago, Andy and Zanna and I met down at Cutter's for lunch, and I told Andy that I was his biggest fan. He got embarrassed by that. But I was Andy's biggest fan not because he was going to be a rock star. I was Andy's biggest fan because Andy is who Andy was. I mean, Andy was, if you met him, and I know most of you guys in here did meet him, you loved him like I loved him. The only way I'm going to get through this is the strength that I'm going to gain from having the kids that I got left. His brothers, Kevin and Brian and Zanna. You guys got to take care of yourself. I can't go through this. And again, you guys in the band, oh, I bet you got, you feel like you're sold out. But Andy didn't do this to you. He had everything in the world to live for, and he wanted to live for you. I want you guys to go on and be the biggest stars you can be. I want to see you guys on TV. If you got to get another singer, don't get a junkie.
Biggest thing that really happened with him dying sort of affects the whole country as far as music goes, because what was happening then with commercial hard rock was it was eating itself. It was totally imploding. No one cared about songs. You just had to look a certain way. You had to sound a certain way. Songs were pretty much the last thing anybody worried about. And Mother Love Bone, they fit into this genre, but they were real, you know? It was like a band stepping out of 1976, and it was that genuine. And they influenced a lot of bands, but I think with Andy dying, and then that band dying, there's nothing left for that genre. And it also created a situation where Pearl Jam happened.
I think about it in terms of, you know, the success that we've had, and that, you know, sometimes think that, you know, if he'd only been able to last through that last year, that he really could have sort of settled into himself a little bit more and really found, you know, what he was looking for, you know, and stood up kind of for himself a little bit more and kind of been a little more sort of assertive in making himself happy, you know, or finding out what it was that was going to make him happy. So I think about that, but not that much. Mostly I just think it's... Mostly I just laugh, think about funny things that he did.
That was like a dream, you know? You know, it's still like hard to believe it even happened. The only way I know that it did happen is that, you know, I can't get on the phone and call up Andy and talk to him, you know? And he's just gone.
If I could use the film as a vehicle to make the world a better place, this is gonna make me cry. I would tell the world to notice their kids. I would tell them to know that every single thing they say is golden. Don't forget, don't get too busy. Because they are a gift. I didn't notice him, you know. I didn't notice any of those kids when they were little. And I know they were just these pure golden gifts for me to enjoy. And I didn't know that until Andy left, you know, and we lost him.
What I would say to him? Wait for me. I want to know what else to say. I still love you.
Surreal. I was out of town. I was in New York and flew back because he was in the hospital and he was on a respirator or whatever whatever they are that they plug you up to, and they were gonna pull the plug and Zen had them wait until I got there. Which, on the one hand, it's like, wow, that's really cool. On the other hand, it's like, well, that's really creepy. It's really awful, you know. Those families all sitting there waiting to just get this over with, and so. That kind of made it especially weird. I didn't want to feel like I was the guy that was like holding up this inevitability.